Hello again and welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In the previous section we created a new calendar called Building Calendar, and it had different hours of work from the ones that come by default with Project 2013 in the standard calendar. We're now going to make that the standard calendar for our current building project, and then we're going to look at some of the consequences of that. We also still need to add the rest of the public holidays to that calendar. So let's get started. So first of all, let's go to the project tab, and then on the project tab in the properties group, click on project information. Now when you click on project information, you'll see that the calendar in force is still the standard calendar. So I'm going to change that now to be the building calendar. Click on OK, and the calendar that I've selected there is now effectively the base calendar for this project. Now you may have noticed a slight change to the schedule there, and the slight change to the schedule there is because the resources that are currently scheduled to work on the project, that's basically the bricklayer and the carpenter, because their calendars are still based on the original standard calendar, will not be fully available to this project during the hours of work on this project, because they still have as their calendars the 8 to 5 hours, whereas the building calendar is basically on the 9 to 6 hours. Now basically the majority of people working on this project will be working to the same hours as the project itself. So let's go in and look at those individual resources and make sure that we've got their calendars set up correctly. So I'm going to use the button on the status bar at the bottom to switch to the resource sheet. And then on the resource sheet, I'm just going to double click on bricklayer, open up the resource information for bricklayer, and in terms of working time, if I click on change working time for bricklayer, I'll see that the resource calendar for bricklayer is currently set at the standard calendar. Now I want to change that to be the building calendar. Now I can't emphasize enough that the only reason I'm having to do that is because I didn't set that up before I started. If you set your calendar correctly before you start scheduling tasks and resources, then you won't need to go through all of this. Having said that, at least I'm doing it early on in the process, so I'm aligning everything before I've entered too much information into my project. So for the bricklayer, the default working week is the one on the calendar, building calendar. So click on OK. That will have now corrected the working time for bricklayer. And then if I do the same for the carpenter, who's my other work resource, again click on change working time, and his calendar is based on the building calendar as well. Now again, I should point out here that although the resource calendar for carpenter has as its base calendar the building calendar, if I wanted to put some exceptions for the carpenter, I could do them here. The exceptions for working time for carpenter, for instance, would be things like the carpenter's vacations. If a carpenter's going to take a couple of weeks off, I can actually record that as an exception here. If the carpenter, for instance, has to go to the dentist one day, I can actually put a 2 or 3 hour exception in here. So you can define exceptions for individual resources. Click on OK, click on OK again, and now I've corrected the calendars for the two work resources, the bricklayer and carpenter, and they're the only ones I'll need to do. And from now on, any work resources that I add will have their calendars based on the new building calendar and not on the original calendar, so I won't have to go through this process again. So now I'm going to go back into the project tab, change working time, and look again at the building calendar, which is now marked as project calendar. You can see the two exceptions I've got there, Easter Monday and Christmas. And what I now need to do is to add the rest of the public holidays for this year. Now, if you're actually following this course in a subsequent year beyond 2013, then I hope you're going to adapt this accordingly. But the next thing for you to do is to add the rest of those public holidays. Add them for the year that you're following this course in, which might be 2013, might be 2014, 2015. And where you have a holiday that can be repeated, probably on an annual basis, something like Christmas Day or any other day that's a fixed date in the year, then schedule it up to 2020. You could schedule it even farther if you want to, but schedule it to at least 2020. Now, I appreciate that depending on your locale, your public holidays may be different. I've actually put two UK public holidays there. There's a few more. If you're in the USA, then you may have state public holidays as well. In any other country, you'll have your own public holidays. I'd like you to schedule the public holidays for your locale. I should also point out to you that since this project is the one that we're going to be using from now on, then if you have different public holidays to mine, then you may find that dates subsequently on the course may differ anyway. That's absolutely not a problem, but it does mean that when I talk about dates later on, yours may be slightly different from mine because of public holidays. Okay, so that's your next exercise. I've saved this project exactly as it is as example 7. And my answer to this current exercise, based on UK public holidays, is example 8. And if you'd like to use different public holidays, that's fine. If you want to follow the UK public holidays, then you can pick up after this from example 8, which has the UK public holidays in it. That's it for this section. I'll see you in the next one.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.